This is Madden 19. I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see a man back for a 15th NFL season. Eli Manning and the New York Football Giants as they'll take on Josh McCown and the New York Jets. With that, we head up to MetLife Stadium as we'll hand it over to the two men that'll call the action, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with that other team here in the metropolitan area, the New York Giants. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Jets ball club. They come in right at 500, looking to get that win to bump them back above 500.
This game means a lot to them because of what you just talked about. When you can bump yourself over 500, it's a lot of optimism in your building as you move forward in the season.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Giants, an early season tilt. And when it's an early season tilt, should be ready to roll.
Well, let's face it, the aches and pains haven't really set in yet. And both teams eyeing a really good start to get things going.
Here's the Jets' new kicker, Cairo Santos, to get us started. Just about time to rock as Toe gets ready to meet leather. Cody Latimer now on the return. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game. It'll be the now 37-year-old quarterback calling the shots in his 15th season at the helm of the Giants, Eli Manning.
When you look at the numbers that Eli Manning posted in 2017, there's plenty of cause for concern. Lowest yards per completion of his career, fewest yards passing since 2008. His numbers continue to drop in terms of touchdowns and rising in terms of interceptions. But he's one of the fiercest competitors in the league, even if you can't tell it by his demeanor. And no, you don't hear about his workout program like Tom Brady and Drew Brees. But this is a guy that burns to win and wants to get back on the top of the heap.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 32 that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So in Jet territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. Manning now on first down. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Sometimes the most effective routes are the ones that you run in the backyard. You probably ran them when you were 5 years old. What about a little curl there against zone? But the key to it is finding the open spots in the zone. How a linebacker or a defensive back will widen to give you space. Find that area and let your quarterback hit you.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third.
Touchdown, Giants! Evan Engram, 39 yards. And the Giants are going to take a first quarter lead.
Could not have scripted it any better. And many offenses do script their opening possession on offense. They followed that one perfectly. Took the ball right downfield and scored, giving energy not just to the offensive unit, but to their team overall.
Aldrick Rosas on for the extra point. PAT up and good by Rosas. And it's now a 7-0 game. Rosas now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out onto the field comes the New York Jets offense, their quarterback situation. We talked about it last week. You know, Sam Darnold figures to be the guy, but social media was all ablaze with Teddy Bridgewater talk last week.
As well it should have been. He was terrific in their second preseason game, played a lot of series, moved around well, threw the ball well. The team moved the ball up and down the field.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. B.J. Goodson. In from his linebacker spot, he's able to drop him for a loss of about 10.
And so much for that great field position to start the game. Now they're way behind the sticks. Can't wait to see what their second down call is going to look like now.
On second down, here's McCown. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On third and long, it's McCown. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. They do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's fourth down.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent gain. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. On fourth down, here's Lachlan Edwards to punt it. Taking it about the 16. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
Manning, flush to his right. Now he's going to let it go deep, right side. And this is caught. Right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. A first down carry for Barkley. And down inside the 15 he goes. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
And you remember pre-draft, there's a lot of speculation that the Giants should look for their future quarterback at number two with a great possibility. Remember, Sam Darnold from USC was still on the board, but they passed on him to take this runner, Saquon Barkley. And this is exactly why. They think he can extend the life of Eli Manning's career and give them 1,000-yard seasons year after year.
They haven't had a 1,000-yard season since 2012. Ahmad Bradshaw did it then. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more. And a look now at how the Jets line up defensively.
I wanted to highlight the back end of this defense and especially focus in on the safety duo of Jamal Adams and Marcus May. Adams, their first-round pick. May, their second-round pick. And both had tremendous rookie seasons. Both can play free safety or strong safety. I call them mirrors. What one is doing, the other's doing the opposite.
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. Shifts by him. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. Give him a gain of four, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now.
And that's why you spend a first-round draft pick on a running back, not for just the fancy runs, but these dirty, gritty third and ones, third and twos. That's why you draft him.
They've made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation they've been prepping for. From the gun, it's Manning, escaping the pressure right. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Evan Engram with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Giants add on to their lead. Still first quarter, two receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to him. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area wherever he lines up to at least try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
Rosas good with the extra point, and that'll make the score 14 to zip. So the drive there took six plays, and it was polished off by a Giants touchdown. Rosas now to kick this one away. Ardarius Stewart now on the return, and they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. So we played a quarter here in this inter-city rivalry. 14-0 is our score, and we will return to MetLife Stadium after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you, it's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number two here. They've got a second down and eight to start things out. They go again with Powell, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and set them down.
Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Alec Ogletree. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Well, right now, Charles, we sit in the thick of preseason. And, of course, that means we're in the thick of fantasy football draft season. Yes. So, you know, the top five. It's good to have David Johnson back. Le'Veon Bell, of course. Gurley, Ezekiel Elliott, Antonio Brown, all studs. Who would you take number one in a fantasy draft?
Oh, that's a tough one. But I would look at Todd Gurley and David Johnson as my top two picks. Johnson missed all of last season with a wrist injury. And with potentially a rookie quarterback there and a little bit of a rebuild, he may get more work than he can possibly handle. Todd Gurley was a beast for L.A. last year, running it and catching it. But how about a rookie by the name of Saquon Barkley with the Giants? I think he'll get a ton of touches. And Alvin Kamara, he showed what he could do last year, both running it and catching it. And don't forget, returning it as well.
They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Now Manning throwing on second down.
tapped in. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Henry Anderson able to drop him for a loss of four.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face, not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. Throwing is Manning on third down. It's caught, Shepard. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Manning going to come up on first and 10, and he's completed all seven of his passes thus far. Throwing on first down is Manning. Flushed out right. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he's brought down. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And 10. Here's Manning being chased out left. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
Illegal touching. Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Manning, eluding the pressure right. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. These offensive starters still out there in the second quarter. You would think the plans for them to at least play into the third quarter, if not all the way through it.
Yeah, it might go by feel. If they have a really good first drive to start the third quarter, they might pull them after that. If not, might leave them out there a little bit longer. But I'll guarantee this, they'll be gone by the start of the fourth quarter.
Throw on third down, Manning. He finds Beckham complete. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20.
Holding offense.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating? The guys who just gave up that play.
So now they assess a third and long, and that holding call might have knocked him out of field goal range, at least for the moment. On third and long, it's Manning. And incomplete on the deep ball. You know, last week I remember asking you, what would an offensive coordinator be looking for week two of the preseason? Now we're in week three. Defensive coordinator-wise, what's he looking at?
For the most part in preseason, you're playing pretty basic stuff, pretty vanilla defenses. You're looking for guys that play with abandon, that just go out and make plays. You kind of let their athletic ability take over in order for you to notice them.
Dick Jackson, the punter, is on as he sends it away. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the five. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here.
And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
They begin with a carry for Powell, and they'll hit him for a loss as he's back to his 2-yard line. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 14.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Two minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Again, it's Powell. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the 6. The veteran Connor Barwin in on the stop.
I think if they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. McCown going to hand this one off to Powell. And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
There's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. That's taking it around the 40. So a change of possession here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. And now out come the Giants.
They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot. Great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
On first down, Manning to Shepard, complete over the middle. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Manning now 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys at 1st and 10. Manning now on 1st down. Buying time to his left. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive game.
Three down. That's it. Blue 80.
going to throw on second down.
And this is caught.
For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Pass interference, defense.
And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty, no question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty
would
do? I
don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
PAT up and good by Rosas. And that makes the score 21 to zip. Rosas now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Josh McCown of the Jet offense heading back out there.
If second quarter, they're down big already. He's struggling as well. They've got to find something here. He's got to find something on this drive.
And sometimes you take on all that extra pressure on yourself and maybe you have to disperse it a little bit. Lean on some other people, lean on your teammates, find someone who can take the pressure off and get the ball in their hands for a while.
Or this, if he doesn't, this is getting out of hand, or it could get worse.
The final shot before half for McCown. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. So we've reached halftime with a visiting Giants, I guess you could say, on top of the Jets in this New York rivalry. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. This one of six games kicking off on this Friday night, as we are less than 2 weeks away from the start of the regular season on September 6th.